Hi guys! It's KLKS na. Knowledge learned, knowledge shared. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Our topic for today for our KLKS tutorial, all about the field property. Using the Microsoft Access, KLKS na tayo! What is database field property? Field property describes the characteristics and behavior of data. A field's data type is the most important property because it determines what kind of data the field can store. The field properties affect how the data is stored and presented, among other things. On our design view, we do have field name for ID and name, wherein the data type is auto number, and we do have the short text for the name. So below, we do have the field properties. Okay, so what this field property is all about? So by default, once you open your computer, the setting of the field property for ID using the data type auto number, we do have the field size using the long integer, the new values which is increment, the format is null, the caption is null, it is index, yes, no, duplicate, and text align is general. And what is the function of this default field property using the auto number? So basically, once we come up with the records on our data sheet view, it simply identifies that our ID will always begin with 1, 2, 3 every time that we will be identifying any information. So, but the question is, pwede ba natin iset ang ating ID na hindi 1, 2, 3 lang? So, the answer is yes. See to it that we click on the desired field name, which is the ID. Then afterwards, on the field property, all you have to do is to identify your format. So let us assume we wanted to start instead of 1, start with 1001, 1002, 1003, so on and so forth. So all we have to do is to type on the format value, we have to type 1000, then press enter. Okay, so what will happen? So automatically, our ID will start with 1001, 1002, and 1003. So that is the first identity of our field property. Okay, so let us go now with the next functionality of our field property. Let us try to erase 1000. So this time, we will be using another functionality of our field property. But we can also set our new values instead of increment, we will be using random. Okay, so meron tayong warning alert. So, once you save the change to the data type of this column, you will not be able to change back to the previous data type. So, pag na-click daw tayo ng yes, automatic niya tayo pwedeng bumalik pa sa increment. So, random na lang yung magagamit natin. So, be careful in using this new values under random because you cannot change back your data type anymore to increment unless you will going to create another table. So it will only affect on the next value with the use of random, since we already done identifying the first three data with increment. So on the port or value for ID, we'll now set on a random number. So let us try to check. Mm, Okay, so let us go now with the next functionality of our auto number. So going back with our design view. So design, another identity of our ID using the data type auto number is the field size. So using this field size, we do have another sets of size that we can also use, and this is what we call the replication ID. Okay, so we do have another alert. So once you save the change to the data type of this column, you will not be able to change back to the previous data type. Once we click yes, we cannot change the value anymore. Let us try in order for us to identify what is this replication ID all about. So going back with data sheet. Save. So using the replication ID, we do have sets of number, computer generated number, and combination of number letters separated with dash. And basically, it can be used registration number or even the access number. So we call it the replication ID. For the purpose of our auto number, we're done with the field size, new values, format. Caption is only a label. It is optional if we wanted to put a caption or not. So by default, if it is primary key, it must be yes, no duplicates. And with regards with the text align, so we can also identify the left, center, right, or distribute with regards with the alignment. Wa tayo ng student ID. And since we're done with the auto number, gabitin natin ng ating student ID as number. So pagka sinabi nating number, the user can set information or set data on our student ID. Hindi kagaya ng auto number, computer will be the one to generate number. How are we going to format our student ID using the data type number if we wanted to appear a leading zero on a number? Okay, para naman sa name, so the purpose of using less than on the name is to convert the output into lowercase. On the other hand, the purpose of using greater than on the full name is to convert the output into capital letter. Okay, let us go now with the age. Okay, so let us try to set our age. Assuming ang pwede lang yung tanggapin ay lahat ng age that is 18 years old and above. So punta na tayo sa ating age. So using the validation rule, we can set our age greater than or equal to 18. So press enter tayo. Ibig sabihin, lahat lang yung tatanggapin niya na age is greater than or equal to 18. Actually, may kapartner yung validation rule. We call it the validation text. Siyempre, kung mag-set tayo ng rule, dapat inform natin si user kung ano yung dahilan kung bakit hindi inaccept yung certain age sa information o sa database natin. So, we can set our validation text. Then, walagyan natin, only 18 years old and above. O ang input mask actually ginagamit siya to set a pattern. So meron siyang ellipse sa gilid. So yes, click lang natin ang yes to save our work. Okay, so ito yung input mask wizard. Which input mask matches how you want the data to look? So ito yung kauna-unahan actually applicability ng input mask is through the use of a password. Pero commonly, as I have said, so, once na select natin yung password pattern, then next lang natin, then next, then finish. Okay, so automatic we do have our value for our input mask, which is the password. Okay, let us go now with the amount. So we do have the currency. And for the department, we will be using the default value. So assuming, or for the purpose of our demonstration, para saan ang default value? If You will notice sa ating lahat ng data type, meron tayong makikitang required. Number man to, o short text man to, currency man to, meron siyang required. So, para saan yung required na to? So, in the event wherein, ayaw natin magkaroon ng empty spaces o empty information. Our index, yung allow zero length, naka-yes siya automatic. Ibig sabihin, zero is allowed in our value. So, para naman sa index, yes, duplicate. Okay, so, since hindi naman tayo naka-primary key, ibig sabihin, okay lang na merong magkaparehas na information with regards with our field name. Pero let us assume, ayaw natin magkaroon ng magkakaparehas na value kahit hindi siya primary key, we can of course set our index yes, no, duplicate. Okay, so assuming lang kung sakaling meron tayong cases na hindi siya primary key pero we don't want duplicate information, pero commonly naman ang mga no duplication, or we call it the unique information, commonly it was declared under primary. So what else? So ito lang yung mga commonly used para sa field property. Okay, so let us go now with our information. Tignan natin kung ano yung magiging output. If we set our field property based on this field name and data type. So, save na natin then. Save, then go to our data. The declaration of our student ID using format, we come up with 6 different zeros. So what does it mean? So if we wanted to appear a leading zero on our student ID, assuming the ID is only 120, so instead of appearing 120, there will be leading zero on our body. Did you guys with the name? If we will still remember, the setting of our name identified for less than. So what does it mean? So let us assume I will be typing a name. So we do have Kent in capital letter. So once I press enter, automatically it will be converted to small letter. So using the surname, we are using a format of greater than. So Ruiz in small letter, once I press enter, it automatically converted to capital letter. Okay, for our age, our validation rule uses greater than or equal to 18. If I will be typing 12, then press enter. So there will be a validation error or validation message. We call it only 18 years old and above. So if I press enter, of course, I will be notified that only 18 years old and above is the accepted age. Let us assume I will be using 19. Okay, for the PIN code, our declaration for the PIN code is under input mask, password. So in other words, anything that I will going to type will be hidden, and the representation of the asterisk is only the output based on the word the user identified. Okay, for the amount, since it is currency, automatically we do have the peso sign and the decimal. And of course, since it is automatically currency, there will be comma in the thousand. Okay, for the department, as we all know, using the default value, we don't need to type the customer service anymore. It's automatically done for us because it is our automatic value. Earlier, we set our name and surname required yes. So, what will happen kung ibablanko natin ang name at saka surname? So, assuming we will be using then, okay, so okay. So, ito yung once na nagblanko tayo, since nag-record tayo kanina ng yes para sa name and surname, so you must enter a value for the name field. Okay, so that's it for our field property. Hope you learned something. Thank you for watching KLKS. See you on our next tutorial.